Bill, are you at your house?
I am at my house and in my dining room.
Not all in your house.
Yeah, we all know.
I like coffee.
You're like my mom.
Okay, great. So we are going to get started. Just so to be able to respect your time. Welcome everyone. I can't believe we're actually saying this and doing this, but we are coming back in person for quarter four. So that's going to be very exciting. It's been, as we were just saying, it's been a long year, but we're coming back after, you know, all of the stuff, all of the social distancing and the sheltering in place. And so we're coming back. So I'm super excited. And I personally think that we have a really good situation because out of all of the classes, we were super lucky in terms of not having to change classes, not having to change teachers. Essentially, when we looked at the numbers, third grade was basically a perfect split between myself and Ms. Greenstein, and almost a perfect split in terms of distance learning and in person. So I'm just super excited that I get to continue to teach the same students, all of you, and it's gonna be awesome. If you have any questions, feel free to just kind of, you can chat them to me, or we can talk about them at the end. So let's go ahead and continue on. So I'm Mrs. Real. I just wanted to share a little bit about me. This is my 17th year in education. Never seen anything like it in the 17 years that I have been in education. It has been a year, but it's certainly been a year of growth. I grew up in Massachusetts. I was messing with the kids a little bit this week and doing a leprechaun voice because they're like blown away that, you know, that I have the ability to do accents and things. My husband, two kids, we have a very old 13-year-old lab shepherd. I love coffee and running. And this is my first time, like I said, teaching in a socially distanced classroom. But I said at the very beginning of this, we can do hard things, and we certainly have this quarter. So let's just get right to the nuts and bolts of it. Right down to brass tacks, we are going to have 13 students in our class, which is amazing. That is the lowest number of students in the school, which is really great. The class, I'll show you a picture in a second. Our class is able to be socially distanced with not a ton of change. And so there's gonna be 13 students in our class. They will follow the guidelines provided by the CDC. Students will be 6 feet apart. There will be protective shields, which I'll share with you in a second. It will be all self-contained learning, so we won't be swapping teachers or classrooms or spaces. But we, within the confines of our classroom, we will certainly try to do small group instruction, small group reading, and whatnot. The kids will have 2 math breaks a day. So we'll talk a little bit more about that, what that will look like. And the focus will be on ELA and math. So whereas we offered social studies and science sort of as an end of the day activity, the focus will just be on ELA and math. And so let me show you what our classroom will look like. So here it is. It's not super pretty. There's not a lot of frills there, but the goal is just to really make sure the kids are safe and protected. And so those shields are there. They can be removed. You can see some of them don't have those shields on them. We can take them down and put them up. Really the goal is just to have that protection. We'll have those layers with masks, but kids will be in rows. It won't be kind of the small groups that maybe you've seen in the past, but obviously that's for safety and to follow those guidelines of 6 feet apart. So we have to mask up, obviously. If you watched the video, Miss Sisney and Miss Pugh did a great job. There are fourth grade teachers of sharing the ways to wear our masks, about how we have to have our masks over our nose. It has to be able to fit. You know, kids will be required to wear masks all day. And again, that's for the safety of the students and also, you know, the staff, any staff that comes into contact with them. We will have two mask breaks. So the way our schedule works, and I know that the kids are gonna have questions about food because they're always hungry. So we'll talk about that too. I already got two phone calls about that. So we'll talk about that too. There will be two mask breaks. So we'll have, school will start at 8:05. We'll have a mask break at 10:15, and then we'll have another one at 11:45, which is kind of nice because that's how we'll end the day. And so really their day will be over at 11:45, and they'll have the opportunity to play on the playground and take their masks off for that. And then they'll have the opportunity to socialize. So really their day's over at 11:45, and that last chunk will be sort of late. And the way that works out is nice because we'll talk about drop-off procedures, and you'll see where your student will be dropped off in just a minute. So again, as we said, two mask breaks, one at 10:15, one at 11:45. Resident rock star mom Michelle was kind of talking about different ideas. We bought lanyards at the beginning of the year. And so we're hoping to I have to find them. They're somewhere. But just to have them around the kids' necks, they're green, so that if a mask gets lost, anyone staff will know, oh, that must be a third grade mask. And then they can sort of bring that to them. But with lanyards, they have a little clip on the bottom. So we figured the kids could just put their masks that. And then that way that, they'll just have it with them. They can, clip it and move as they want. Obviously, we want to keep it safe. We don't want it. I'm a mom, so I've found masks in weird places. But we want to make sure that we keep them, close off the floor. We don't want any unnecessary dirt or grime or germs on them. And so really we're looking at doing the lanyard as well. And then food and drink, again, I know that this is a big one. So kids have asked me already, what can we eat? And the short answer is yes. But what I will say is that I do feel like during this distance learning time, we have sort of had free reign of, getting a snack whenever we want. So over break, it might be a good idea to remind your student that that you'll only have a short amount of time to eat. So so snacks that are easy to eat, maybe not, the sandwich spread that lasts 20 minutes, but I'm not gonna name names. I'm not gonna say anything. But just making sure that you can have something that you can grab and go, because one of the mask breaks will also serve as PE time. And so we're not gonna not allow kids to eat, obviously, because that's a long time to go from 8:05 to 11:45. That's certainly not the intent. But we also want them to move their bodies and get that PE time. So they'll have PE twice a week, and then a mask break twice a week at that same time. So if it's a PE day, maybe packing something like a Go-Gurt or like something quick, a granola bar, something that doesn't take them 10 minutes to eat. They can just sort of, okay, we're good to go, and then move to PE. And then I would just recommend making sure that they have a decent breakfast, just because we don't have the flexibility to say, obviously we can make, exceptions if kids are having a really hard time, but we don't have the flexibility to kind of go where and when we please. And so just to be mindful of that. And if we forget our masks, we do have some on campus that students, so it won't be like, you can't come to school because you don't have a mask. We have plenty that have been donated on campus. So just something to be aware of on that. Let me check. I see some friends. It's just a few friends asking. Hopefully that question was answered about how many students are in each class. There are 14 in Miss G's class and 13 in our class. So we do have the best numbers in terms of low ratios. And so I'm super grateful for that. And hi, docs, how are you? Okay, let's take a look at our next slide. So getting here, so arrival begins at 7:55. So some friends are gonna need to roll that alarm clock back a little bit. And maybe it's a good opportunity to practice over the next 2 weeks. I know it's late, but just a reminder, school does start at 8:05. Students will be dropped off by the back of the playground and will enter through the far gym door. So on the Kari Loop, if you can remember a year ago, although some of you I know are doing it now, on the Kari Loop, there is actually another entrance to the playground. It's sort of a fence. And so I assume that students will be coming up through there, up the steps, where they used to come in the morning. They would go up those steps and then to the hall and then straight down to the third grade classrooms. And you'll see there's a green flag. Currently, we just have K-2 on campus. So there's, you know, orange, red, and yellow flags, and also like little signs, and we'll have the same for third as well. All belongings will stay with student will stay with the student. So they'll have their backpacks on their chair. Ideally, if you could provide a pouch or a pencil case for materials, just so it's contained, that would be helpful. They're going to have a self-contained bin, so their bin will stay next to them. They won't get up, and like in the past, we've had kids get up, put their bins away, and then go. That won't be happening. They'll just have kind of like their little station. And then something that we thought of that would be really, really helpful is just like those personal hand sanitizers at their desk. And like those personal tissue packs in case they do need to like blow their nose or something happens, just so that it's not the constant, I need a tissue, you know, and it's not that back and forth touch. Although obviously we know, you know, with the current science that that touch is not as big of a concern, but we still want to minimize the touch back and forth. So those personal hand sanitizers and tissue packs are ideal. And we'll talk a little bit more about supplies in just. We talked a little bit more about this, but students will have two breaks throughout the day, 10:15 and 11:45. I want to talk about the restroom because I want to be very clear that we are like, we are not bathroom monitors. We are not like, we're not trying to make sure that you know, students can't go to the bathroom. But it does get a little challenging with kids going back and forth. And so essentially what's going to happen is that each kid will be assigned a number, and that is the stall that they will use. And the purpose of that is for contact. So if there is a positive case of COVID on campus, we do need to be able to identify, you know, where that student was. And so if, you know, if there's a student that's using stall 5 and they come back with a positive COVID test, we do have to be able to report that so the sanitizing can happen. And so the goal, obviously, there will be mask breaks. So at 10:15, they can use the restroom. At 11:45, they can use the restroom. You know, at 8 o'clock, they can use the restroom before they go. But we do ask that, you know, nobody's chugging a Gatorade on the way to campus, right? Just like, you know, we're all sort of getting back to training our bladders and making sure that our bodies are in the routine. And so we just want to hopefully be proactive about using the restroom so that, because we only really have about an hour of instruction for each subject. And so when it comes down to it, we just want to make sure that we're maximizing that time. And of course, if your student has to go, you know, it's not that they can't go to the bathroom, we just want to be as safe as possible. And obviously if there are special cases, of course, we can have a conversation about that. Okay, so this is a little snippet of what our schedule is going to look like. So when students come in, there will be morning work and intervention time. So that morning work time is going to look like a writing prompt. We're going to have work like the Zern or the Reflex that they're currently doing. And then also that'll be our time to pull students. If a student doesn't understand a lesson, with some of you, I have had a conversation, you a text, hey, can your student hop on Zoom real quick? I just wanted to go back over the lesson. So really having that time to say, okay, I'm gonna work with this student on this concept and then this student on this concept and this student on this concept. It's just a great opportunity for us to have that one-on-one instruction time to reinforce things that we can. We'll have morning meeting at 8:45 to 9:05. And then we'll jump right into ELA at 9:05. Our ELA will consist of reading and writing, language work, and then we'll do the reading groups that we had been doing when your student was meeting with us once a week. And then during that time, they'll be continuing on with the ELA menu, which is what they've been doing this whole time. There is some crossover with our distance learning students, as well as the in-person students. We all plan together. So we have the same materials. And both Ms. Machini and Ms. Greenstein, we've all sort of, you know, taken ownership of that. And so we've tried to design it so that, you know, it can be done at home, it can be done at school, that kind of thing. And then PE, Ms. Greenstein, her class will be on Monday and Wednesday. Our class will be on Tuesday and Thursday, and playground. So Tuesday, Thursday, Monday, Wednesday. So we will have those break times built in, which is really nice. So the kids will have the opportunity to socialize. They will have the opportunity to, you know, interact. Obviously, you know, ideal. We know that kids are kids. We want to keep them as safe as possible. So again, like we are not, you know, we're not the mask police. We're not the social distance police, but we do just want to remind them to stay safe. And so they'll still have the opportunity to play and talk and have fun. But it might just look a little bit different. And then we'll come back in. We will have math from 10:30 to 11:30. Again, I cannot stress enough how lucky I feel that we have such small ratios. So even if we did two small groups in math, the biggest group size is gonna be like somewhere around 7. And so that part is really cool. The way that we've set up our rooms, we sort of have whiteboards on two sides. So the goal is really to differentiate for the students who need extra support versus the students who can work more independently, and then flip-flopping on that. We will also have support from Ms. Diaz. So Ms. Diaz will be supporting us as well with some student needs. And then Ms. Nalika will also be in our class. She's new this year. So that's very exciting. We should be able to get a lot done. And then at 11:30, we will pack up and have our closing meeting, just sort of a quick whip around of, you know, how was today, a question. We always try to do some kind of closure to bring the day to a close. And then they get to end with recess. I personally love that. We did that last year. For those kiddos can remember that we used to have recess from 2:30 to 2:45 when we went to school until 2:45. And I always really enjoyed that because it was like, cool, pack up and let's just enjoy the rest of the day. And so just a great way to send them off and go home. See you. I did just want to make a note of it. We're going to do our best to not have any homework. So the goal is just going to be, they may have Zern, but again, obviously we'll talk a little bit more about that in terms of ability to have those devices at home. And we do have that morning time. So we're still kind of working it out. We would still like them to continue on with fluency because that is one of our school-wide goals, and some of our kiddos are still working to meet that, that 110 word per minute average by the end of the year. But the work there, it's not like they'll come home at 12:05 and then, okay, now you have two more hours of asynchronous work. That's not the case. We're gonna work them at school, and then we will release them to relax and hopefully ease them back into being in that classroom. Okay, so again, a little bit more about classroom procedures. So there will still be a Google Classroom, and most students were very proactive and joined. And then there were just a few who hadn't. I caught a few on Zoom today, so they joined. And it just is labeled Mrs. Real's in-person classroom. It will not be like it is right now where it's like, okay, 9:05, we're gonna do morning meeting and then we're gonna do this and we're gonna do that because we have that schedule and you don't have to worry about that anymore. But there will still be some assignments. We will likely do the exit tickets online. We will likely do some assignments, assessments and things online as well. So. Just be aware of that, but it's going to look very minimal. So if you look at it and you're like, this is not a lot of work, it's because we're doing the bulk of the work in class, just like we did pre-pandemic. And again, we said only homework will be Zern in 20 minutes of reading. The goal will really just to have us, and if we can get fluency done in person, that's our goal too. It will be in sort of an interactive notebook, but really our goal is to just have them read at home and then the Zern. And then Fridays will include morning meeting and be asynchronous work at home. So very similar to what's happening now on Fridays. I did note that Chromebooks will come home on a limited basis. So there's a quick survey that I would love for you to take before you leave tonight, just so we know who actually does have access. It will not be a ton of work on the Chromebook, but we will do morning meeting. Well, we do dialogue circle on Friday. And so it will be that, and then similar to what they're doing. Okay. And then supply list. Okay, so this is very similar to the very beginning of the year. Chromebook and charger, school issued, please bring that back because we do need that. We are going to go through and sort of reissue. This is probably a pipe dream, but if you still have the green, purple, and orange folders that I gave you at the beginning of the year, if you could please bring them back, that would be awesome. If you don't have them and you're scrambling, let me know. I can order some, but we want to try and minimize our orders because we're moving campuses and there's going to be a lot of need next year. And so the goal is just to sort of work with what we have. If you have the whiteboard that we issued you, you could bring that back. That would be great. Expo markers and an eraser. You can use an old sock, not an old sock, like a sock that's clean, hopefully, for erasing if you don't have an eraser. And then markers, some kind of marker and crayons or colored pencils, something for them to use. A lot of this stuff I would assume students already have because we've been using it the whole year. But headphones for their Chromebook, whatever they're already using, a chapter book or your novel for morning reading, personalized mini hand sanitizer, personalized mini tissue packs, and then just ideally a black composition notebook. Because they're going to be doing journal prompts, and then a personal water bottle that is hopefully filled in the morning before school starts, because there will be limited access to the water. It's not just going to be, hey, can I go get a drink at the water fountain? That's just not possible right now with all of the moving parts. And so just filling that water beforehand would be great. And obviously, if you cannot provide these, I know that the pandemic has hit people in different ways. If you can't provide these, let me know and we'll have enough materials for everybody. Nobody will go without, but I just wanted to share that with you. Let's see. Oh, awesome. Okay, thank you. Thanks, Michelle. You're so awesome always. Okay, so we have some action items. I don't really want to call it homework, but I would love for you to, and you don't even have to do number one because it's already done, your kids did it for you. Join the new Google Classroom. If you are already a Guardian, it will sync automatically. You'll just see it in your classroom app. Take the tech survey. So I'm going to put the link in the chat in just a second. And it just basically says, do you have technology that, excuse me, that you can use on Fridays or not? And the reason for this is that we are a little bit worried about the kids coming back and forth with their Chromebooks, just the wear and tear. And we wouldn't be able to send the Chromebook charger home. We're gonna keep them in school because we'll need to charge them on Monday mornings. So I'm going to put that survey in the chat in just a second. And then if you're not on the Remind app, it's just a quick way to send out blasts to you. I don't use it as often as I did when we were in session, but with that, it'll just be really helpful. It's just a helpful way for me to get a quick message out to you. And I'm, as a parent, I'm actually on a text group with my child's teacher, and it's like 20 numbers. And I just don't want, I know that people have, you know, certain concerns around privacy and whatnot. So the Remind app is just sort of a group, and it's just a generic message that goes out. I mean, obviously you all have my personal phone number. That has not changed, nor will it. So you are always free to text me. And then this is super exciting. We're going to wear our class colors the first week back, which are green. And then where's Michelle? Is she on here? She was on here. Her face is not on here. Her beautiful picture is on here. But Michelle, there she, oh, nope, she was coming. Then she didn't. Michelle is, if you have not seen her work, she does really great work. And so she has offered, and along with a little something for me to make class shirts for our kiddos. So she's going to make class shirts for our kiddos, kind of all about, she's very creative and very crafty. And so she's been kicking around some different names. And so what I will say is that I would like to do this. And she said that she would like to do it as well. But if you would like to donate to that effort, let me know and we can kind of organize on the side. But super awesome. I think it would be really fun. I told her as soon as we found out that we could share that we were going back, I just want this this return to be really special for the kids. It's been a really long year. And whatever we can do to make it fun and special and to make it memorable, I want to, because I think that they deserve it. And so please, if you could just send it to me in the chat, provide me with your child's shirt size. And then Michelle and I will take care of the rest. And if you want to send a donation her way for the shirts and the materials, that would be great. But I would like to do that for the kids as well. And so, yeah. So I know that there are probably questions. So feel free. I'm going to stop the presentation. I'm going to put that link in the chat so you can see it. And just if you could please take that survey, that would be awesome. And so feel free to ask away. The kids know how to use the hand raise button. And so again, please feel free to raise your hand and ask any questions that I did not cover, because I'm sure that I forgot something. I'm going to go ahead and put that link in the chat if you want to do that right now. Okay, cool. Thank you. Amy, yes.
So the kids are not going to be sitting in class in front of their Chromebooks, right?
Correct.
So the other kids that decided to stay home, their whole days are changing to go around the kids that are going in person?
Kind of. So that's a really good question.
Okay.
But I think that some people are not sure about. So what a lot of the school districts are doing is they are doing the whole concurrent learning model where you know, teachers are teaching in the classroom and the kids are on their Chromebooks and there are kids at home also doing Zoom and listening. And that is not what NP3 is doing. We are so fortunate to have Ms. Machini this year. And she has really been a huge help with you know, numbers and supporting kids. We had some individual needs that needed to be met. And so because we have Ms. Machini's class will essentially become a new class. So this, everyone who's on this, and I think it's almost everybody, which is really cool. This is our new class, 13 of us. That's it. We are our new class. And I know that it is, it's sad in a lot of ways because maybe classmates that we saw, you know, a lot, we won't get to see because we won't be on Zoom with them. But the hope is that we'll be back in person in August, fully. And then we'll get to see those students again. So really now there will be three different third grade classes, our in-person, Ms. G's in-person, and then Ms. Machini's distance learning class. Does that make sense?
Yeah, and so I heard drop-off was, you guys orchestrated something like new and improved.
Yeah, so the way the drop-off has kind of been working is that there are different entrances. There are gonna be different entrances for every grade level to avoid kind of the crossing. Yeah, so essentially what the plan is right now, although it may be subject to change because there's been some change this week with K2 drop off. What right now the plan is to have students in third grade. So you'll go around the car loop and right before you come kind of swing back, I don't know if you've ever noticed it, but there's a gate. There's a second gate to the playground. It's always closed for safety reasons, but the kids will just be dropped off there. So they'll come in there. And that's sort of where they'll enter. And then they'll go right up the steps. And basically where they came in last year, they'll go right up the steps through the gym and straight down to the third grade classrooms, past the old art room, straight down to the third grade, fourth grade, fifth grade hallway. So no crossing. The goal is just to really kind of streamline. And it's been great. And my thing is, like, if K2 can do it, third grade, fourth grade, fifth grade, this should be a snap, you know? So yeah. Great question, Amy. All right. Any other questions? Guys are quiet. Oh, yes. Yes, please.
Hey, can you hear me okay?
Yeah, I can.
Alrighty. So I think I know the answer already, but this is true for Miss G's class as well, right?
Yes.
Perfect. So, all right, guys, got it? Cool. We're good. Thank you.
Yes. Yes. In fact, Miss G used the exact same presentation. She just changed her Bitmoji. So,
oh, yeah, we missed that one. So,
that's okay. Yep. You got it here. Same thing.
Perfect. Thank you.
And just to be very clear, like, we plan to everything together. We make all the same copies. We share assessments. I mean, this whole year we've shared students. And so the way that we look at it, our team looks at it, is that they're all our students. So even if I don't get to have Darsh, you know, I had him for math and I'll still see him. We've gotten to know almost all of the students this year. So yes, perfect. They're all our students.
And so, thank you.
Yep.
Thank
you. Yes. Edlyn, did you have a question? Uh-oh, you're on mute. There we go.
Yeah, hi. So quick question. I missed that part just a little bit. For the reading groups or the groups you had mentioned, so do the kids actually, like, get together or change seats for that part, or?
No.
Okay.
So, well, yes, and the short answer is no, but we are trying to orchestrate the classroom so that the desks are, you know, what we've done is we've created two spaces so that there will be two separate whiteboards. So they will, in a way, sort of have their own sort of personal group. The thing that we need to be mindful of, honestly, is the contact tracing. So if a student does, you know, for whatever reason, have COVID, we have to know where that student has been. And so for that, like, they can't get up and, like, you know, Peyton can't get up and get a book in the library and then, you know, see Arian on the way back and high five him and have him pick a book. Like, we can't, there's not going to be as much movement as there has been in the past, but our staff, especially our K2, has been really great about creating activities and things. And honestly, I do think that the time just going to go by really fast when we've had small cohorts of students who do have, specific needs in the classroom, and the time really goes by fast. You know, we've had them for an hour.
Okay.
So we are going to do our very best to make it engaging and fun. And I have tried to place students next to kids. Could backfire, but I'm gonna go for it. kids that I know that they interact with, just so they can sort of have a buddy in class. We're trying to be as strategic as possible. We're trying to make it fun and exciting. And I will say that the overwhelming feedback has just been that the kids are just glad to be back. And so they don't even really care what they're doing. They're just happy to be back in person and see their friends. And the biggest complaint I did hear from a kindergartner today was that he did not get enough playtime. We're gonna make sure they have plenty of opportunities to socialize.
Of course. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Sounds good. Thank you.
Of course. Okay. I know. I mean, they're not coming back to collaboration and small groups and, you know, high fives and all that stuff. We're going to do our very best to make sure that they feel that connection, and we're going to spend the first week just sort of getting back to, you know, that face-to-face interaction. The goal is not to use our Chromebooks the first week. So, you know, they'll just really have that time to connect with their themselves. I mean, I think that like, it's just going to be an adjustment too. Like if you want to tune out, you can't just turn your screen off, or you can't just mute and get up and walk around. And so, you know, really it's just going to be getting back to those expectations of how to be a student, how to be an 8-year-old with other kids in class, what, you know, in a lot of ways it'll be more of the socialization in the social emotional. So, yeah. So I did just share, yes, another question. Did you guys have another question? Bowender, no? Oh, sorry, I saw your hand. The boys do the same thing. That's so funny. I love it when parents and kids are just the same. It makes my heart happy. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, so any other questions? The presentation, hi guys. The presentation is going to be available as soon as the recording will be available to you as soon as I can stop it and get it converted. And so if you could just do me a favor and please put your child's shirt size in the chat, that would be really great. And then Michelle has lots of good ideas and we'll be in touch. Maybe the t-shirt fairy will come and stop at your house over break. I don't know. I was supposed to go to Hawaii and I'm not. So Natomas is the next best thing, I think. So so we will have lots of little surprises for the kids. And you know, my commitment is just to make it as fun as possible. And you know, it's just been such a long year. And so I just want them to just be able to have that time to enjoy each other and hopefully remember what they loved about NP3. Yes, Peyton, did you have a question?
Yeah. Do you know how every week there's a media of the week and you give them donuts?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Is that still going to happen when we're in person?
Would you like me to still continue to do it?
Yeah.
Sure. Okay, we can do that. I haven't thought that far ahead. I was just trying to work on making sure I was ready for conferences, but sure. You know, and the really cool thing about this is that because we're so small, I mean, we only have 13 students, we're going to be able to get a lot done. And there's going to be a lot more that we can do that maybe we wouldn't be able to do with 24. Not to discount the fact that there are some students who are choosing to stay home at all, but I'm excited just to really have just such a small, special group. So I'm super excited about that. So feel free to stay on and ask questions. I appreciate everything. We had this whole plan at the very beginning of the summer. I was on the committee and we literally met every day. Okay, what are we going to do? 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 And then July 15th happened and we went into distance learning. And so I'm just so excited. We have been ready for this for a long time. We're so excited. Even just in Carline, when I see some of the kids, hi! And so my goal is just to be committed as much as possible and also make sure that they are getting what they need. And if they've missed anything, I'm filling those gaps as well. But you guys have just done as a parent. I know what you're going through. I know that it hasn't been easy. I know that you've had to adjust your schedules and change things around. And it's frustrating and stressful. And I just want to say thank you because your kids are growing. Just looking at the data today and doing conferences, like I'm just blown away by how much they really have grown since the beginning of the year. And it just proves that, you know, when we all work together, anything is possible. And so I just thank you for your commitment. And I hope that as soon as you drop your kid off at 8:05 on Monday, April 5th, go somewhere with your spouse, with your friends, and just celebrate the fact that you made it. You know, I know that this has been a lot, but you guys have been really, really an amazing community. And so I'm excited. It's going to be awesome. It's going to be really fun. I'm super excited. Thank you for everything. If you don't have any more questions, if you could please, I'm going to share it one more time. If you could please take the tech survey, just so I get a quick idea. And then if you could, again, drop your students' shirt size in the chat. Thank you again for everything. And I will see you, well, I'll see you on Zoom for conferences. See you on April 5th in person with those masks. We'll talk more about that. I'm gonna locate those lanyards. It's the last thing I do. And I'm really excited for all of you and for us. So, all right, friends, I will see all of you children tomorrow morning for our dialogue circle at 9 a.m. Get excited for that. And have a great night.
You too. Thank you.
Thanks, bye. Guys. Feel free to stay on and ask questions if you have them. But other than that, thank you so much. Bye, Arielle. Bye, Jeremy. Bye, guys.
We had a couple questions. Sorry.
Yeah, of course. Ask away.
So do you know how many students you're going to have in person right now?
Yes. So I'm just going to.